intimidate.
Ow!
Can you hear me in the back?
Yeah.
Yo.
Good enough. I'm quite drunk, though. And I just wanted to say.
Demanding. Hazel handed is my style, my smile.
smiles candid, never sanded back. I do not slap or strike unless I'm bidden, hesitant to bite when bitten, twice as shy as I, as silent as the starry sky. I listen. But when given cause, I tilted into blizzards, been to war or cinders, stumbled, stilted, orchestrated, ordered, hinted, in a million whips of words and mirrors, wrought and fought and stirred. I've sprinted for the win and splintered, done a stint, been runner-up, run down, run out of town, outrun, outdone, and spun like Rumpelstiltskin. Some could say I've won sometimes, or lost between the lines. And once or twice, I've been impressive, silhouetted in successive victories and shone reflective. That all said, I'm not aggressive.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, in a public room, they're not aggressive. In rehearsal, they were fucking terrible.
You don't do it.
But for recording purposes, I'm going to use it anyway.
Oh yeah, this is going to be on my next album, so pretend you're a much larger crowd.
Hang on, how many of you had an 80s childhood?
You!
Okay, 5 of you are lying. I don't know what that means. I'm not.
This part which we should get on with is
in the movie of our lives.
You will be played by Richard Grieco. Look that up.
And I'll be played by Johnny Depp. You don't need to look that up. And don't you ever forget it. Who remembers the last time they saw a Richard Grieco movie and said,
damn, it was good. And I wish I hadn't blown my voice out on the first one. Damn, it was good. Can we hire that VHS? You might need to look this up too. That VHS tape again tomorrow night to see his impersonation of someone who almost had a decent acting career, but sadly couldn't act, just smoke a lot.
And that's you,
fucker.
What's he done since Booker?
What have you done since high school to heroin?
And you call me a loser for smoking pot? Well, now
who gets to eat shit?
Because I'm John Lennon.
And you're Paul McCartney.
No one loves you, even though I've been dead for a very long time. Not me, not you.
And not you.
Plastic Ono Man.
Wings.
Plastic Ono Man.
Wings, yep, you're definitely McCartney. How do you feel now, you talentless hack?
If we were a Corey movie, look it up.
Corey Haim and Corey Feldman.
And I'd be Heather Graham. Please don't tell me you need to look that up. Who's got the career now, you little bitches? Because I'm Amanda Holyfield.
And you're my Tyson. Ding! Have another year, Mr. Tyson. Your career is also over.
Except we're all suffering from that hangover. Finally, there's a reference that you'll get. If we were Batman villains, I'd be Catwoman.
You'd be the Penguin.
If we were 50s teen idols, I'd be James Dean.
You'd be Frankie Avalon.
I'd be Chuck Berry.
You'd be Cliff Richard.
I'd be Different Strokes.
And you're just Webster.
I'm skipping the Bush Kangaroo.
And you're the appalling Bob Morrison show.
He doesn't know what that means either.
And you're Steve Beiser.
You don't know what that means. I'm Wheel of Fortune.
And you're Keynotes of Richard Wilkins.
If we were scenes from Basic Instinct, I'd be the lesbian sex scene they cut out because the test audiences are stupid.
And you'd be Michael Douglas's ass!
If we were Al Pacino films, it'd be Doctor Afternoon with John Cazales.
And you'd be sent to a woman with, remember this guy, Chris O'Donnell.
If we were Yahoo Serious Films, you remember, oh come on. I'd be young Einstein and he'd be
Mr. X, let's see my fucking words.
But I have the good sense never to speak of it again. I'm Yoda.
And you're Howard the Duck.
You're macking me.
I'm Crocodile Dundee, you're number three. I'm Ice T.
You're T-Pain.
I'm Ice Cube.
You're Lil Wayne.
I'm Iceberg Slim.
You're cool as ice, starring Vanilla Ice.
Ice, baby. Sorry. I'm the Bionic Woman.
You're the Flying Nun.
I'm J.O.K.
And you're the Seekers.
I am Frank Zappa.
And you're Tipper Gore.
And you are not the mother of invention yet.
You're the lady pig in the ass.
If we were Liberace's dressing room, I'd be the fancy sequin jacket.
And you would be the wire coat hanger he complained about because it made the whole room look cheap.
I'm Paul Newman.
And you're Tom Cruise.
You fucking Scientologist. I'm an orgasm.
You have nothing but a quick fuck.
And if I got anything of you, I'd make you yours. Or you be you.
But you're still Paul.
And that's how little you matter to us.
You're the guys who hid behind terrorism because you're just greedy bastards.
And we're the guy that wrote Give Peace a Chance. They shot the wrong beetle, and everybody knows it.
In the poem of our lives, you'd be a pop culture reference that the audience doesn't understand. We'd be a clever metaphor, more than a last-ditch attempt to half-hitch the audience's goldfish attention span. The 9.9 score. What's that smell? Those guys' stuff's way past its best before. In the poem of our lives, you'd be a parade of lame celebrity guests. The audience tried to Google them, but they got bored and did the next Candy Crush quest. I'd say you jumped the shark, but I think you water skied directly into its jaws. She looked that one up. Here's the title for your next chapbook. TV Week. Yeah, TV Week, March 1984. Our work, they say. No wonder that got published, brother. Your work, they say. I missed that episode of that show. Our work, they say, those poets have the words to win. Your work, they say, I don't know it and I've never heard of him. You're alienating the audience. You're giving them the shits. Look at them all, scratching their heads. And it can't all be the next. If I took out the pop culture, your tome would shrink to a page. If it was sport and not movies, you'd be booed off the stage.
Are you booing?
Your favorite band sucks.
Cheesy and paltry, seven of them all. Swept up the night before and served cold. Jelly meat, like what Timbers used to eat. With indecipherable additives like Corey, Corey, and Corey. Face it, your work's dated from the get-go. Just out of touch, not cool enough to be retro. The 80s is over. It's time to let go.
Thing that we were going to do that was going to...
Are you
going to
tell them about it?
Yeah, I'm going to tell them. We have this funny thing that we were going to do that was going to surprise the twins.
We were about to
read their last poem. We were going to make out with each other and they weren't going to see it coming and it was going to be really hilarious.
And then Brandon...
No one in Sydney, unbeknownst to us, unbeknownst to them, that already happened. So our finishing gag is really kind of fucked on now. So
do it anyway.
The twins are going to read theirs, and we would have really, 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 really appreciated it if someone came up on stage and made out with them and drew that final poem that really helped us out.
No, that would have been.
I'm not going to say who anyone in particular should bring to
I make it really hard on myself.
With less than amazing grace,
I have rage.
Bleeding off pages, head cased over 100 stages in front of
complete strangers, scaring the shit out of them.
Then having to hand it back in
a stinking, stupid balancing act. Apologize to the emotionally comatose who live.
Living TV highlight, life supported.
On a bland diet of early nights.
Like those people who are
almost comfortable.
Oh, shout out to Jamie and Carly, who stuck around. Thank you. There was 8 people who were going to leave, and we talked to them at the stadium, and then they bought us wine.
Do I think they had important things to do? The other 3 were following the hot girls that had important things.
On a bland diet of early nights, I have conquered entire words.
Swallowing my smile back, fulcruming back my foolhardy
into muscle and more muscle. I've done push-ups on the sun, sweated the lead out.
Cracked ribs while laughing.
And made midnight wince at seeing me again. I fucked the holes in my story.
Ate her out with knuckle-loved hunger, glared obnoxious at every curve.
Part has bodily separated us from our true story.
I wanted her so bad.
Then it was bad. Punched the pain of that into myself.
Tried using some bruises to prove that maybe, somehow.
Oh, we really connected.
Died of embarrassment to see if
suicide is painless.
Or just another of life's creative processes bargained on.
No pain, no gain.
No matter how often I was subsequently shortchanged.
I have paid my dues into black and demanded some bloody payback.
When it was my show. Voice stereo dialed up to 11!
Screaming God fucking diamonds!
Right up into the heart of heaven.
I read every religious book back to itself like a lullaby.
Believing I had shed myself of every belief.
In spirited arguments.
With God, it goes.
I broke the light bulb in my brain, beating my head against every wall I could find out there.
blame.
To get this gravel in my voice, I travel the whole world.
It's a shitty rhyme, but...
like I said, I make it hard on myself.
Kept it up, trying to die with bell toll and token cake.
But I'm telling it straight.
Screw the food.
In a glass house. Blew my chances.
Give it a toss, gamble and you lost.
I'm gonna have to go sleep it off. Shit where I've eaten.
To then eat
shit boat rot.
Judgment snap.
I have to cut the crap.
But in all that,
I have never, ever done anything
at all
that could stop me thinking.
Thinking about you.
Before I dusted it. Well, I donated it as a raffle prize. That way no one would win.
Unfortunately, your submission has been unsuccessful. Please feel free to never submit to us ever again!
Because you didn't react strongly enough to Random Growing Pains that you were going to finish with this. It's very simple. Elvis has left the building. He's not dead. He just heard the palm and he walked out. Then he kicked a puppy.
On the one hand, please make your feelings known for the tag team that is known as Banner.
Can I buy one right now?